Going to tell you how can you make a liquid determination, liquid limit determination table and its graph, because it's quite difficult to make it. And after watching this video, it will be helpful for you. How can you make a liquid limit determination graph? It is purely from soil mechanics, so it is very helpful for the students of civil engineering department. So what you have to do first, I have already discussed about how to make a sieve analysis graph. So there is one sheet over here that is on the sieve analysis graph. So what you have to do, you should rename it, because it will be easier for you to open sheet by sheet whatever you have done. So I'm writing here, it's sieve analysis graph, sieve analysis. So I have changed this name. So I wrote it sieve analysis here, and next I have a sheet where I'm going to find out liquid limit. So what I have to write it down, liquid limit determination here. So this is the way you can provide the name of the sheet. So now what you have to do, for example, I am writing here liquid limit determination, and liquid limit determination. So in the next line, I am writing that the soil which I have taken is that the soil passing from the sieve number 40. So what I have to do, I should write down here number 40. So whenever I open this document, I can find it out that we have taken soil from the passing from sieve number 40. So what I have to do, write it down here, that is observation number here. So, and the next point will be the container number, weight of wet soil plus container, W2 in grams. Now what you have to write down, weight of dry soil plus container, and this will be W1. This is W1. Now what you have to write it down, for example, I wrote by mistake, it's a typing mistake of the value, spelling of the weight. So what should I have to do? W-I-E-I-G-H-T, it is the weight. Then what you have to do next, you have to write down the weight of the container which I have taken before starting testing. So what I have to write it down here, grams, weight of container. Then what I have to write it down, weight of wet soil is also in grams. Now what I have to write down, weight of dry soil. So it is weight of W-E-I-G-H-T, weight of dry soil. So it is also in grams. And then what I have to do, weight of water. I will tell you how can you calculate it. So you should write down weight of water here. And then what you have to do, this is also in grams, because you subtract it from the other values, so it will be in grams. So what you have to do next, there will be the water content in percentage. So you can write it in the form of WN. The variable you can show is the W, or you can say omega. So for example, I'm writing here W, and it is capital N. And what I have to do in next, water content should be in percentage. Number of blows. Number of blows here. Liquid limit. Limit. LL, the short form you can see. So you have to write down full stop as well. Then you have to calculate average water content. Then it is also in percentage. So what you have to do, for example, this is let me do this like this. So this is the better way to do this. Now what I am doing, there were three observations which I have taken, so I have write down the observation number. This is observation number three. So what I have to do next, it's that what is the name of the container. So I have to write down SM58, then there is container number SM43, then there is SM34. So what I have to do next, I have done this practical in the lab, soil laboratory. So these values I got it. This is 30. This is also 30. This is 34. So this is what? This is 28. This should also be 28. This is 30. These are the values I got it in the university or in the lab of the university. Then the weight of the container, this comes out to be 16. This is also 16. This weight of the container is 18. So next, what I have to do, I have to write down weight of wet soil. I have to calculate it. So how can I calculate it? I have to subtract weight of container from this value. So how can I do that? So for example, this value is bigger than minus subtract this value. So I will get the weight of the soil. So I have to do this, and this way I can easily calculate the weight of the wet soil. So next, what I have to do, and let me do and it. Now what I have to do here, I have to do put equals to sign here, and from this value I have to subtract. For example, which value I have to subtract? I have to subtract the weight of the container. So first I have to take this value and subtract it from this value, so I will get the weight of the dry soil. So this is the way to calculate the weight of the dry soil. So what I have to do, I am getting, for example, value 12. So W1 minus weight of the container. So dry soil, we have to, for example, you can see I have subtracted weight of dry soil plus container minus weight of container. So I will get the weight of dry soil. This is the way to calculate it. And then I will drag the box here and I will get all the values. So I am getting same values, like weight of dry soil is 12, is also coming out 12. Why is it so? So actually it is coming out, it is same again. And the next value is also same, because that is the weight is 30 and it is coming out to be 18. So that's why I'm getting this value. So you, these are the ways to calculate it, and you can calculate easily in this way. So what I have to do next, I have to calculate a weight of water here. So how can I calculate the weight of water? So for example, I can do it like, for example, I have to subtract weight of wet soil minus this. So this will be the value, you can see. And I will drag it up to here. This is coming out to be 4, and now I have to calculate weight of water content. Now how can I calculate the water content percentage? So for example, you have to apply the formula, water content in percentage is equals to weight of water divided by weight of dry soil into 100. So how can I write it in the Excel sheet? So I will tell you how can you write it down. So you should take round up formula, and then you have to write down sum, then you have to apply three brackets here, then you have to do what? You have to take water, weight of water divided by, you have to use slash, and weight of dry soil. So you have to take weight of dry soil, then you have to close the bracket, and then you have to apply steric sign, and you have to multiply with 100, then you have to close the bracket, comma 2. It means you want round up to 2 digits. So this is the way to write down the formula. You can easily see, then you can see here round up sum. I'm taking B10 divided by B9 into 100, comma 2. And how many brackets I have used? So I have used a bracket for B10 divided by B9. So start bracket and close bracket. Then I have used another bracket for multiplying with 100. Then I have closed this bracket. Then I have to use another bracket to take whole value for the sum. And then I have taken another bracket for roundup. So this is the way you can do it. And what you have to do next, you are taking this value like this. Now you have to provide number of blows here. So the number of blows which I have applied there. So what were the number of blows? So I should have to write it down here. So it is 13, and it was also 13. So, and it was 41. These were the number of blows which I have applied over there. What I have to do next, I have to provide another formula, that is liquid limit formula. And the liquid limit formula is what? Water content multiplied by number of blows divided by 25, keep that's raised to the power 0.125. So how can I write it down? You can see I should write down round up. And for example, these are the sum brackets, and then I have to provide another brackets. So what will the value here? Water content in percentage. So this will be the water content for this column. And then what I have to do, I have to close this bracket and I have to apply steric, and then I have to start the bracket. And what I have to do, is that I have to take number of blows. So I am taking number of blows from here, and I have to divide number of blows with 25. This is in the formula. Then I have to apply cap sign for the power. Then I have to write down 0.121, and then what I have to do, I have to close the bracket. And how many brackets I have to use? 2 brackets here, and then I have to apply 2 because I want round up to 2 digits, and I have to close the bracket. This is the way to you have to calculate the liquid limit value. Then you are drag it up to here and you will get all the values. Then what I have to do, I want average water content here. So how can I find it out? So I have to do margin center, and I will write it here what? Round up average. And what are you going to do? Average and water content percentage, and you are taking it like this. Then you have to take comma 2, and you have to provide another bracket over here. This is the way to calculate the average water content in percentage. And then I cancel it and save it. And if I want to calculate average liquid limit, so how can I calculate it? Liquid limit, average liquid limit. So just I will drag it down, and what I have to do here, I will select another column of what? Liquid limit. So the formula remains same, so I will get this in this way. So I will make I'm going to make it proper and representable. So how can I do that? So I will select these like this, and I will provide border on it. thick border, and then I am doing what, margin center, and I will provide border also. Then I will select it border, and then what I have, I'm going to do is I will provide border here also. This is should be the border. This is also border. So what I have to do, I will provide it like this. This should be like this. Like this. Now what you have to do, you can bold it, and I am going to make it into center. So this will be in center like this. So I have to make this to be subscript. So I'm going into the format cell and I will do it subscript. So I will going to here format cells and I will make it subscript. This will be the subscript. This should be also be subscript. This is the subscript here. And this is the way you can do the subscript. Now it should be in center. And now what you have to do, you have to make graph. So how can you make the graph? For example, I need values in the vertical column. So how can I do that? So for example, I am writing here number of blows. Not here, let me do it here, for example. Number of blows. Because one value is repeating, so what I have to do, moisture content. Content. Here. And this will be like this, and water content in percentage should be, and this will be here. Number of blows are what? It is equals to this column and equals to this is changed, those both were same like that. So what I have to do here, and I am taking moisture content. That is water content is this, and here I am taking this water content. This is this one. So what I have to do here, I'm going to use this value for the graph. So how can I use it? I will tell you. And this is the way you can represent your work. So for example, I am going to insert graph. Insert a graph, and you are going to use scatter with smooth lines and markers graph, and you can see it is already selected. So I'm going to take a select data and I am going to remove it. It is already selected, so I'm going to add in it, and I'm writing here liquid limit determination. And I have to write down the values in the series X values. So I have to provide number of blows here. And the Y values are this. You have to select this. And it is okay. The graph is done. So what you have to do next here, you have to make this graph bigger. And what you have to do, you have to go into the format axis. And as we have done earlier in the sieve analysis graph, so you have to select logarithmic scale but not in values in reverse order. So major is 5 and minimum is 5, and maximum I can take it is maximum number of rows, it's okay, 40. Now major unit you can provide 2 as well, 10 as well, so it's up to you. Right now I'm taking it as 10, it's okay. Now minimum is taking is 1 at x-axis, so it is 1, okay, but it is it was 40, so it should be 40. Let me remain it like this. So I am moving, I have to put access title here. So how can I put access title? So I am going to select this and I will provide access title here. So the access title here is water content in percentage. I have taken here. So I will provide it. And here should be what? I have taken log n value. Log n means number of blows in logarithmic scale. So I can write it here like this. So what I have to do next, I have to provide add minor axis, and I have to make it bigger in size. So how can I make it? I am going into the home tab, bold it, and you have to select Times New Roman here. Writing style, and you can increase its size. You can select its size as well. So how can you do that? You can go into the Times New Roman, you can increase its size, make it bold, change its color because it is showing that it is gray color. And which size I have taken? 16. So I have to say same size. So what I have to do, I have to select this value, bold, Times New Roman, and it's 14 or 16, and it should be black. What I have to do, it's I have also have to increase its size as well. So I can make it bold, and I have to take Times New Roman, select it. And Times New Roman, it should be 16. I'm taking it, it's up to you, it's your choice. It's not necessary you have to do it like this, whatever I'm telling you. It's according to your choice as well, but I'm just giving you the guidelines and directions. So you have to select this and you make it black. What I'm going to do next, I am going to select this sides, and I will make its outline dark. How can I make it? I have to increase its weight and then its outline and its weight also. So this is the way you can change its color, format, axis, outline. I'm taking, for example, dark green color. And again, for example, I have to change its color as well. And I am changing it into purple color. You can see it is looking quite better or attractive as well. So these are the some ways to make your presentation, make your graphs attractive for the reader, audience, or teacher. So it's up to you. You can do it whatever you want to. For example, I'm taking its color is maroon and it will look nice. And this is the way you can make your graph for liquid limit determination. Hopefully you can understand it and you will be able to draw your graph after watching this video. So I hope so, it will be helpful for you. How can you make your liquid limit determination graph and how can you make your graph on an MS Excel? And thanks for today, and I have to finish this video up till here, and that's it. Goodbye.